but I'm going to southwestern France this summer, and I'm really hoping that I can get there. I may be able to. Have you been? Okay, let's see. Is Tim? Tim's up there? He's ready. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the old meeting house, to this Teze service, this service of sung prayers, sung chants, both from the French community of Teze as well as from local Vermont composer and retired minister, Kathy Wanson Eddy. So we invite you to enjoy singing along, sing in harmony, sing in unison, listen, go back and forth, do what feels right to you, and just know that we're all welcome at this service in whatever way we are coming today and tonight. I thought I would start and end the service tonight with some readings from John O'Donohue's book, To Bless the Space Between Us, which is one of my favorites. And we'll start with Vespers. As light departs to let the earth be one with night, silence deepens in the mind and thoughts grow slow. The basket of twilight brims over with colors gathered from within the secret meadows of the day and offered like blessings to the gathering tenebrae. After the day's frenzy, may the heart grow still, gracious in thought for all the day brought, surprises that dawn could never have dreamed, the blue silence that came to still the mind, the quiver of mystery at the edge of a glimpse, the golden echoes of worlds behind voices. Tense faces unable to hide what gripped the heart, the abrupt cut of a glance or a word that hurt, the flame of longing that distance darkened, bouquets of memory gathered on the heart's altar, the thorns of absence in the rose of dream. And the whole while, the unknown underworld of the mind turning slowly in its secret orbit. May the blessing of sleep bring refreshment and release, and the angel of the moon call the rivers of dream to soften the hardened earth of the outside life. Disentangle from the trapped nets the hurt and sorrow, and awaken the young soul for the new tomorrow. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. This one will go back and forth between the English and the French, and the French goes like this. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi, la nuit comme le jour est lumière. And don't worry if you get it wrong. We'll start in English.
The darkness is never darkness in your sight. The deepest night is clear as the day.
One more time in English.
Our darkness is never darkness in your sight. The deepest night is clear as the daylight. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi. La nuit comme le jour est lumière. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi. La nuit comme le jour est lumière. Our darkness is never darkness in your sight. The deepest night is clear as the day.
Again, our darkness.
Our darkness is never darkness in your sight. The deepest night is clear as the daylight. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi. La nuit comme le jour est lumière. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi. La nuit comme le jour est lumière. Our darkness is never darkness in your sight. The deepest night is clear as the daylight. Our darkness is never darkness in your sight. The deepest night is clear as the daylight. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi. La nuit comme le jour est lumière. La ténèbre n'est point ténèbre devant toi. La nuit comme le jour est lumière. Our darkness is never darkness in your sight. The
The scripture reading is from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 1 through 31. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry of her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out. In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are grass. That's constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of the Lord blows upon it, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. Who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand and marked off the heavens with a span, enclosed the dust of the earth in a measure and weighed the mountains in scales and the hills in balance? Who has directed the spirit of the Lord, or as his counselor has instructed him? Whom did he consult for his enlightenment? And who taught him the path of justice? Who taught him knowledge and showed him the way of understanding? Even the nations are like a drop from a bucket and are accounted as dust on the scales. See, he takes up the isles like fine dust. Lebanon would not provide fuel enough, nor are its animals enough for a burnt offering. All the nations are as nothing before him. They are accounted by him as less than nothing and emptiness. To whom then will you liken God, or what likeness compare with him? An idol? A workman casts it, and a goldsmith overlays it with gold and casts it for silver chains. As a gift, one chooses mulberry wood, wood that will not rot. Then seeks out a skilled artisan to set up an image that will not topple. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretch out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me, or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power. Not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Here ends the reading.
Christ, the risen one, you stand here among us. Rise again in our lives. Christ, the risen one, you stand here among us.
I invite you in this next chant, if you wish, to come up and light a candle, say a prayer. No hurry, no pressure, at your own pace, and we'll just keep singing, humming, intoning this next chant.
In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. My sod alone my soul can find rest and peace. In God my peace and joy. Only in God my soul can find its rest. Find its rest and peace. In God alone my soul can find rest and peace. stand in awe of God. I 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 stand in awe of God. Of God.
Second scripture reading is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 1 through 10 and 16 through 21. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this tent we groan, longing to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling, if indeed when we have taken it off, we will not be found naked. For while we are still in this tent, we groan under our burden, because we wish not to be unclothed, but to be further clothed, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. He who has prepared us for this very thing is God, who has given us the Spirit as a guarantee. So we are always confident, even though we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we do have confidence, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please Him. For all of us must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense for what has been done in the body, whether good or evil. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view, even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view. We know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of the reconciled to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ. Since God is making his appeal through us, we entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God for our sake. He made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
Let your light, O God, shine through me. Let your light, O God, shine through me. Light shine. Through me.
May all that is unforgiven in you be released. May your fears yield their deepest tranquillities. May all that is unlived in you blossom into a future graced with love. Amen.